In this tutorial, I will guide you step by step on how to create a Wi-Fi mesh network using old routers. Mesh networks are a great way to extend your Wi-Fi coverage and eliminate dead zones in your home or office. I will cover topics such as configuring the primary router, connecting the secondary routers. Here I have two used routers and I mark them as router 1 and router 2. For router 1, you connect one of its LAN ports to your computer. This is the NetGR 6220 router. To use routers as mesh network nodes, you use firmware called OpenWRT. You can install OpenWRT on different routers. And you turn old routers into OpenWRT routers with the same operating system. OpenWRT helps you connect routers together to create a mesh Wi-Fi network. Here are the steps to install OpenWRT on NetGR router. You download the two files above to your computer. After downloading the necessary files, connect your computer to the NetGR router and access the router management page. Next, you upgrade the firmware for it. You browse to the file called factory and upload it to your router. For each type of router, there is a different way to install OpenWRT. My router 2 is a TP-Link router and the way to install OpenWRT on it will be different. You just need to follow the instructions on the OpenWRT homepage and you will be successful. The default IP address is 192.168.1.1. By default, the login password is blank. Next, you upgrade the OpenWRT router using the second file downloaded in the previous step. You browse to the file called size upgrade and upload it to your router. By default, the login password is blank. Then you connect router 1 to the internet using the one port. By default, OpenWRT does not have a package available that allows you to configure a Wi-Fi mesh network. So you add the mesh package. You open the software menu from the drop-down list. Among the packages that are installed by default is a package called WPAD Basic. You remove it from router 1. Next, you search for packages named WPAD. In the list that appears, install the package called WPAD Mesh OpenSSL. This is a package that helps you set up a Wi-Fi mesh network. WPAD Mesh OpenSSL is installed. Next, I show you how to create a new mesh node with router 1. You access the wireless menu from the drop-down list. Router 1 has two bands. I use N-band to connect mesh nodes. You set up mesh nodes to have the same channel together. In this case, I use channel 1 to connect mesh nodes. Next, you set up the node mesh as follows. In the drop-down list, select 802.11s. Then you set the mesh ID. Here I set it as my mesh. In a mesh network, nodes have the same mesh ID setting. You apply the changes and enable it. So I have completed creating a new node mesh. I recommend that you write down the mesh node configuration information on router 1, such as channel, mesh ID, mode. Because you configured the same on router 2. The next steps are to install OpenWRT on router 2 and configure node mesh on it. My router 2 is TP-Link Archer C7, I searched OpenWRT firmware for it. Just like router 1, I downloaded two files to turn router 2 into an open WRT router. But unlike router 1, TP-Link C7 router has a different way to install OpenWRT. Here are the steps to install OpenWRT on TP-Link C7 router. You can refer to how to install on your router on the OpenWRT homepage. For the TP-Link C7 router, you use file transfer software called TFTPD. You copy the two files you just downloaded to a folder named TFTPD. For the file named Factory, rename it to Archer C7 V2 TP Recovery. Depending on the version you are using, change the name accordingly. For TP-Link Archer C7 router, there are 6 different versions. Next, you set up a static IP address for your computer. You set the IP address 192.168.0.66 for your computer. Next, use a network cable to connect the computer to one of the LAN ports of router 2. Then you run the software called TFTPD and make sure to allow it through your computer's firewall. On the router there is a button called Reset. Press and hold the Reset button, and turn on the power to router 2. Router 2 will boot into recovery mode. The OpenWRT firmware file will be uploaded to your router. After a few minutes, router 2 will turn into an OpenWRT router like router 1. You look at the log on the TFTPD software to make sure the firmware file has been successfully uploaded to router 2. Now I set the IP address on my computer in dynamic mode to get the IP address from router 2. After completing the firmware upgrade on router 2, it will assign an address to my computer via the LAN port. And this is the TP-Link Archer C7 router after completing the OpenWRT installation. Just like router 1, I upgraded the OpenWRT firmware using a file called size upgrade. By default, the LAN IP addresses of both routers are the same, so they will conflict. So I will change the LAN IP address of router 2. I set router 2's LAN IP address to 192.168.10.1. LAN IP address has been changed to 192.168.10.1. By default, the OpenWRT login password is blank. Next, connect router 1 and router 2 together so that router 2 can connect to the internet. You use a network cable to connect from the LAN port of router 1 to the WAN port of router 2. The LAN addresses of the two routers are different. Router 1's LAN address is 192.168.1.1. Router 2's LAN address is 192.168.10.1. so you will not have an IP address conflict. This is router 2, it is connected to the internet. Next, I introduce how to configure node mesh on router 2. You access the software menu from the drop-down list. You remove the package named WPOD Basic. Then you search for the package named WPOD Mesh OpenSSL and install it. You install the same package as on router 1. I recommend that you restart the router if the installation fails. WPOD Mesh OpenSSL has been installed on router 2 just like on router 1. In the following steps, I will guide you to create a second mesh node on router 2. You access wireless from the drop-down menu. As you know, on router 1 I created a mesh node on band N, so on router 2 I created a mesh node on band N. You enable it. You set up the band and channel the same as on router 1. Here I set up channel 1 on router 2 the same as the setup on router 1. In the mode settings list, select 802.11s. Then you set up the mesh ID to be the same as router 1. In this case, I use mesh ID as my mesh for both routers. On router 2, I created a new SSID on the AC band. As you can see, the mesh network has been established between the two routers. The two routers are connected to each other using mesh. I enabled an SSID called OpenWRT. You set up the Wi-Fi network as you wish. I set the Wi-Fi network name to NetVN. Because the two routers connect to each other using mesh, to avoid DHCP server conflicts, disable it on router 2. Devices connected to the Wi-Fi network will be assigned IP addresses from router 1. If you want to access router 2, set a static IP address for your computer according to the IP address range 192.168.10. Please note that the two routers are connecting to each other using a LAN cable. Because the mesh network has been successfully set up, remove the LAN cable between the two routers. Now two routers connect to each other without cables, they use a mesh network. This is router 2, you see that there are no network cables connected to it. But when I use a smartphone connected to it. On smartphones there is still an internet connection. That's great, because router 2 is connected to router 1 using mesh. This is router 1, I will set up the Wi-Fi network the same as on router 2. I recommend you set it up like this for uninterrupted connectivity across devices. Mesh networks provide a great experience when connecting to Wi-Fi, but there is one thing you need to pay attention to. That is, not all routers support mesh. To check if the hardware supports mesh or not, access your router using SSH. Then use the iwlist command. If you see mesh points in the list of supported hardware, congratulations. Your router supports mesh. Above is a list of some routers that support mesh for your reference. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Good luck.